you build me up, but I come, baby, just to let me down. You mess me around and then worst of all, you never call, baby, when you say you will. But I love you still, I need you,
I need you
more than anyone, darling. You know that I have from the start. So build me up, buttercup, don't break my heart. I'll be overrated, for me time and again, but you're late. I'm waiting around the bend, till the door I can't take anymore. It's not you, you let me down again. Now baby, baby, try to find a little time, I'll make you happy. I'll be home, I'll be beside the phone, waiting for you.
We're from 11 Division, and we love stats. Of course, Mami ang tutuan. Sabi na to.
We love stats. Of course,
magaling tutuan. Mikey! We love stats. Of course, alam namin ang technique kung paano kung possible outcome is 3 or 4 points or toss, representing the number of heads or tails.
We love stats. Of course, we know basic random variables, constructing probability distribution, and computing the mean and variance of a discrete probability distribution. Greetings, baby wildcats. In this video, we're delving into the sphere of statistics and probability, specifically exploring key concepts from our second semester pyramid adventure.
Predictable random variables to the art of constructing probability and distributions, and finally, the precision of computing the mean and variance for discrete probability distributions.
Get ready for concise journey of the important tricks that form the backbone of our statistical tools. Let's unravel the intricacies together and make this concept a statistical atlas.
First, let's talk about random variables.
Imagine a random variable as a variable detective that explores different outcomes by chance. Now, there are two types of detectives. First one is discrete detectives. These detectives count as specific, separate possibilities.
Just like in real life, you can think of counting the number of heads when flipping a coin several times. The possible values are discrete, it's specific, and separate.
Continuous detective. They measure things that can be anywhere within a range, like the height of the students.
Continuous detectives. They measure things that can be anywhere within the range, like the height of a student in a class. Consider measuring the height of a student in a class. Height is a continuous random variable. It's not limited to specific values because it can take any value within a range.
Cases, students can understand that discrete variables have distinct, separate outcomes like counting, while continuous variables involve measurement and can take on any value within a range like height or time.
Oh, hi! There you are! Now, let's proceed to constructing probability distribution.
Alright, imagine you're planning a sneak. And you want to predict the weather.
First, list outcomes. List possible weather outcomes like sunny, cloudy, or rainy.
Second, assign probabilities. Estimate the likelihood of each outcome based on past experience or forecast. For example, if it's usually sunny or might give it a higher probability. And lastly, create a simple chart or diagram to show us chances of each weather type. Sunny might be 0.7, cloudy 0.2, and rainy 0.1, as long as they add up to 1.
Now, you've created a probability distribution for picnic weather. It's like predicting the menu of weather possibilities for your outdoor plans.
Next, let's proceed to computing the mean of a discrete probability distribution.
Assign each quiz for a probability based on how likely it is to occur. Example, percentage of students scoring that particular mark. Multiply each score by its probability and add up these products to find the mean, which represents the average of quiz scores. In school terms, it's like predicting the average score for the class by considering how common each
usually get higher scores that will affect the mean.
By relating it to something familiar like quiz scores, students can grasp the concept of computing the mean in a discrete probability distribution.
Lastly, let's talk about computing the variance of a discrete probability distribution.
Let's simplify it. Variance in school life. Again, think about the students of some results. The variance shows how much spread out for standard those assumptions are around the average.
The results vary a lot, the variance is higher, indicating a wider range of performance. If they are close to each other, the variance is lower, showing more consistent results.
In this way, variance helps us understand the extent to which individual exam results deviate from the average, giving insight into the overall variability in performance.
To sum up, we've navigated through the world of statistics and probability, breaking down concepts like random variables, constructing probability distribution, and computing the mean and variance with relatable real-life scenarios, whether predicting picnic weather, analyzing student test scores, or engaging in a coin-tossing game. These concepts are more than just mathematical puzzles. They're tools for understanding uncertainty in our daily lives.
In essence, constructing a probability distribution is like creating a menu of possibilities, assigning probabilities to outcomes. The mean acts as our guide to the average or expected value, offering insights into what we might consider a typical outcome. Meanwhile, the variance measures the variability, helping us grasp the range of possibilities in a given scenario.
As we conclude, let's appreciate that these concepts aren't confined to textbooks. They're practical tools for informed decision making. Probability and statistics empower us to navigate uncertainty, guiding us in making better choices, whether we're planning an event, analyzing data, or playing a game.
Embrace the randomness,
understand the variability,
and let the probabilities illuminate your path, understanding, and dealing with uncertainties.
Thanks for joining us on this journey through the practical and impactful world of statistics and probability. Once again, bye!
Coming home from school.